Hi there, my name's Ed Wicks. I'm one of the educators at the WSET School London, and in this video we'll be going over five things that influence grape growing. The first thing that we're going to be covering that influences grape growing is climate. Climate can be classified in a lot of different ways. The first and very important way that we can classify it is by the average temperature during the growing season. The growing season is defined between the months of April and October in the Northern Hemisphere and October to April in the Southern Hemisphere. Grapevines, like all plants, have an optimal range of temperatures in which they're able to grow. Too cold and the grapevine will struggle to grow and potentially die. Too warm and the grapevine will lack the conditions necessary for a winter dormancy and become stressed and have a reduced lifespan. The temperature in which grapevines are happiest and thrive in is between 16 and 22 degrees Celsius. This can be further cut down into different climate classifications. A cool climate will have an average growing temperature in the growing season below 16.5 degrees Celsius. A moderate climate will be between 16.5 and 18.5 degrees Celsius. A warmer climate will be between 18.5 and 21 degrees Celsius. And the hot climate will be above 21 degrees Celsius. Now, different grape varieties are suited to different ranges of our temperature. Riesling, for example, prefers a cool to moderate climate. However, Grenache would not be able to ripen in these climates, needing a warmer or a hot climate. We typically find these optimal climates between 30 and 50 degrees latitude away from the equator. And you can see that this is going to be home to some of our most famous wine growing areas like California, the Western Cape, France, Italy, and Spain. Another important factor beside the average temperature during the growing season is how much of a difference there is between the coolest point of the year and the warmest point of the year. This is known as continentality. This is influenced by proximity to large bodies of water like oceans. Large bodies of water heat up and cool down slower than bodies of land. This means they'll have a cooling effect in the summer months and a warming effect in the winter months. Therefore, areas under vine nearer to oceans will have less of a difference between the coolest point of the winter and the warmest point of the summer. This will give us a longer growing season with warmer climates in the autumn, allowing our grapes to ripen on the vine for longer. Regions further away from large bodies of water will have high continentality and a bigger difference between the warmest point of the summer and the coolest point of the winter. They'll experience a rapid drop of temperature in the autumn, meaning that we have a shorter growing season. However, we might have a warmer growing season than maritime climates of a similar latitude. If the temperature is also cool in a continental climate, we can see a higher risk of frost as we have cooler springtime temperatures. Continentality will also affect the expected weather patterns of a region. Being close to a large body of water can increase the humidity, cloud cover, and rainfall that we might experience. Maritime climates are defined by having rainfall evenly spaced out through the growing season. The higher amount of rainfall can lead to challenges with rainfall landing during flowering or fruit set, which can reduce yields of our vines, or rainfall falling during harvest, which can cause our grapes to swell and give us dilute flavors in our wines. These more humid conditions can also increase the risk of diseases such as fungal diseases like botrytis. Mediterranean climates also experience low continentality being close to large bodies of water, but these climates are going to be warmer, which means we have warmer, dry summers. This means we don't have the same risks associated with maritime climates based on rainfall during the growing season. However, drought can be an issue in these climates. Continental climates will have much less humidity during the growing season, so it'll be warmer, drier, and sunnier. This allows us to ripen our grapes in the short growing season. However, drought can be an issue. Examples of these climates inside France, a maritime climate could be Bordeaux. Examples of continental climates could be Alsace or Burgundy. A great example of a Mediterranean climate would be the Southern Rhone or the Languedoc region. The second thing we're going to discuss is weather. Whilst climate typically stays the same in our growing areas, weather can see variations, with some years being warmer or some years being cooler than others. Some years could be more rainy and some years could be more sunny. This is going to lead to differences in ripeness of our fruit and then can lead to differences in vintage variation. Some regions that are noted for having a high degree of variance in their vintages is places like Bordeaux, where some years it can be sunny and hot and other years it can be cloudy, cooler and more rainy. Other areas, like the south of Italy, are typically going to be warm, sunny and dry and will experience less vintage variation. Changing weather in our vintages can also lead to various hazards like spring frosts, cold temperatures in the spring, excessive heat, or drought. These hazards that we can find will be covered in a later video. The third thing we're going to discuss is slopes and aspects. Vineyards on slopes get more access to sunlight than vineyards that are planted on the flat, which will experience shade from nearby vines. The aspect of our slopes refers to the direction it points. Vineyards in the northern hemisphere that point towards the south will get more sunlight and more heat during the day as they're pointed towards the equator. This is reversed in the southern hemisphere, with vineyards pointed towards the north, experiencing more sunlight and warmth. This will allow more riper aromas to develop in our fruits over the course of the growing season. Conversely, vineyards that are pointed towards the poles will spend more of the day in the shade and therefore have less sunlight and less warmth than vineyards that point towards the equator. Vineyards on the bottom of the slope will have more fertile soils and cooler air temperatures, meaning that we're going to see a more focus on vegetative growth in our vines and potentially not get the same flavour concentration as a higher quality vineyard. Vineyards at the top of the slope are going to be more exposed to winds and have a cooler air temperature as well, means that we will not get the same concentration of aromas. Where we often find the best vineyards is in the midpoint of the slope, where we have less fertile soils, but get the benefit of that heat and sunlight that the slope provides. This can be seen in the appellation structure of Burgundy, for example, where some of the best vineyards, our Premier Cru and maybe our Grand Cru vineyards, will be aligned in that mid-slope point. Our fourth thing that we're going to discuss is proximity to bodies of water like lakes and rivers. These will heat up and cool down slower than the land nearby, thus helping to moderate the air temperature of nearby vineyards. This can extend the growing season of certain areas into the autumn, as we'll have that little extra warmth that is given from the lake and the river, allowing some riper fruit characteristics to be found. Lakes and rivers can also influence the growing season by providing us mists, particularly in the autumn months, with the nearby vineyards to allow the incursion of botrytis cinerea onto our grapes, to allow the production of nobly rotted fruit for our naturally sweet wines. Vineyards planted near and above rivers and lakes can also benefit from some reflected sunlight, which can give a little boost to photosynthesis, aiding the ripeness of our fruit. Examples where these rivers and lakes play a pivotal role in ripening our fruit can be found in northern Germany in the regions of the Rheingau and the Mosel. The fifth thing we want to talk about today is soil. Soil can affect how our vine ripens in a number of different ways. Stones on the surface of the soil can help absorb heat of the day and radiate it out to our vines, giving that little extra warmth to allow slightly riper grapes. The rest of the soil is going to be made up of smaller particles. The largest of these particles are called sand, and the smallest of these particles are called clay. The soil will also contain decomposing organic matter known as humus. This is going to help fertilize our soils and give nutrients to our vines. Depending on the particle content of our soils, we can see differences in drainage and water retention. Larger particles like sand are more free draining, whereas smaller particles like clay and our humus are going to be more water retentive. The best soils are going to be giving us just enough water for the vine to thrive. Vineyards planted on slopes will also experience more water drainage. It is often thought that mild water stress during the growing season can influence fruit quality, giving us higher quality wines. Just with having too much water in the growing season, too many nutrients in the soils can also lead to vigorous growth and a reduction in the ripeness of our fruit and the lower quality found in many of our wines. Too little nutrients, however, can also be an issue, giving discoloration to our leaves, which means we're not going to see as much photosynthesis and a lack of ripeness in our fruit. This ill health or chlorosis can be rectified by the addition of natural and artificial fertilizers to our soils. Our question for this session is, what is the influence of stones on the surface of a vineyard? This is a question that has two marks. The command verb of this question is what? So this is asking us just to recall a fact, not going into a more detailed description. A model answer for this question, stones absorb the heat from the sun and reflect it to the vines, which aids the grapes whilst ripening. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you found this useful.